want to start a business, get out of the office, achieve happiness and success while crushing life? This is Boss to Boss, the place to be for that extra motivation to get up and follow your dreams while learning from the ones who have already done it. And now for your host, Miro Wieslow.
Welcome to Boss to Boss, your one-stop shop for all the tips and recipes you'll ever need to take control of your life and finally become boss. What is up, everybody? How you doing? How you feeling? We got a special guest in the house today. Yeah. I forgot this thing's recording live, but Steve Wiley himself, that producer you heard about that's lurking in the background.
I'll break your legs.
Up top. He is here today with us, everybody. We're very excited. Very excited. The whole relaunch, everything. It's finally happening. It's finally here.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's super exciting, right?
Yeah. Man, just setting this whole thing up, just getting this awesome studio going and everything, and we're just growing together, you know, mm-hmm. as a company over here that we started, and we want to bring you so much content, so much knowledge, so much new, awesome things every single day, and we're going to do a special episode today since it is going to be the first recap rant episode.
Rant and recap.
The rant and recap.
You'll see that on the website. So,
and the format's going to be a little different. Normally I'll probably just be talking myself and just going on, spitting amazing things to you guys as always. But today, Steve's going to be the one asking the questions. So doing it more interview style based. And you guys will get to know Steve too, the producer behind it all, who's making it happen. And the guy you don't want to meet outside of
5 seconds in a speed round, you know?
Exactly.
But, yeah, awesome. Well,
without further ado, what do you got for me, Steve?
Well, so, you know, we wanted to start this thing off and we wanted to do it right. We want to let everybody know that, we're really working on this in a different way. We're collaborating together. We're putting this together in a way that's going to be just the highest quality content we can possibly make together. We've been putting a lot of time into, the website, social media, obviously launched the YouTube channel, subscribe. Without Miro, there's no boss to boss. Without me, there's no podcast.
Exactly. So Steve has a lot of background, in all types of things, digital, IT, computers, you name it. He's been doing it all since who knows when, right?
Yeah. Well, obviously, intrinsic marketing,
yes.
That's my company. This is my shameless plug. Aside from boss to boss, what I do during my working hours, digital marketing, media services, and things like that. So what we're doing here is we're putting that together in a way that fits. I think it's a really good fit.
I agree.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, with the podcast format, it's something that I wanted to get into definitely for a while, thinking about different ways to kind of reach different audiences and offer content that was actually, important to people. And the reason that I wanted to get in on this with you is because of the fact that I truly believe what you're doing is good. I don't know about you guys, but I think it's pretty interesting.
Appreciate the kind words. And it's kind of a little background really quick. Steve actually came up to me. I had him interviewed at one of my episodes. I think it was like episode 60-something. I had him interviewed, featuring him about his company. We knew each other from back in the day. We used to do telemarketing together, like back when I was in high school, and he approached me with this idea, and I've always wanted to rebrand and just go more professional and just the whole 60, 100 yards, whatever, all of it. And this was the way to do it. And I think a lot of people, a lot of times, the ego gets in the way, and they just want to do it all themselves. Yeah. Just have the full ownership, that full like that. It's just me.
Yeah.
But a lot of times there's usually somebody else there alongside, you need to collaborate, you need to get that synergy going to make things happen. And you can't just, and especially if you're trying to run multi companies or not, you don't just have one thing going on. Yeah. Like for both of us, I have Hodgepodge, he has Intrinsic. There's a lot of other things going on too. Doing it all on your own, you can only get so far. I think there's so much potential. I think it's a little capped when you try to go fully alone.
Yeah, I agree. And that's the thing, And this is something that you've touched on in a lot of the episodes before we start this new format and this new name. You know, a lot of the things that you brought to the table with the Love the Journey podcast was kind of touching on the fact that you have to understand, like, what you're good at. You have to, like, measure what you can do. Learn, as you know, in my experience at least, you know, I'm sure you probably agree, with any type of business, you know, the hardest part is delegating tasks to somebody else. When you start a company or something like that, you know, you want to do it all yourself because you think that you're the only person that can do it right. And the problem is, just like you say, there's a cap. There's only a certain amount of hours in a day that you can use to do all the different things that you want to do.
Exactly.
And you know, an entrepreneur obviously is creative, and you have all these different ideas and things like that. And you know, if you try to do them all yourself and you don't have that ability to delegate that work out to somebody else, what happens is you put a little bit more and a little bit more on your plate, and then all of a sudden you can't even hold it because it's so heavy.
Exactly.
And that's the thing. What you're doing with Hodgepodge, you have a full schedule, obviously.
Oh, yeah.
Anybody does. I mean, I have a full schedule with different things, but we are able together to do it at a higher level because of the little bit of free time that we have, you know, to put this together. It becomes whole.
I agree.
And then also, you know, with the content that you come up with when you're working, I'm sure you think of different things, you know.
Constantly just jotting down notes or ideas of things I could talk about, my little stories of crazy day-to-day things that
rants.
Go on, the little rants.
Rants.
I think I will be doing more Facebook Lives, Instagram Lives, things like that.
Absolutely.
To get those thoughts out. You know, especially in the middle of the day. I have gotten a GoPro and do record a lot of my day-to-day content. A lot of it's in the works, you know, things that we're going to be chopping up and getting out over time. You got to see the madness for yourself, the things that go on, especially if you want to make it happen and, you know, start something up, become a boss, you know, take control of your life. There's a lot of craziness that goes into it day to day, day in, day out. It's definitely exciting, but at the same time, it is stressful. You know, at times it's lonely. At times it's hard. It's not the easiest things, you know, not the easiest of things to do. There's not as many people you can relate to that are doing the same things that you're doing.
You know, for any entrepreneur that's listening, this is probably a story that probably resonates with you. You know, people that are in your circle when you're working for somebody else, coworkers at a job, you know, you guys are kind of like tied together. Because you have that job together, you know, so you have those experiences. And what happens when you decide to take that step and move out of that comfort zone, away from working for somebody else? And those people become less and less able to identify with what you're
just
talking
relates,
about.
Yeah.
You know, you can't relate, you know, so.
Like, I'm busy. Done? I mean, it's past 5 o'clock. It's the weekend.
Absolutely.
It's a little different.
Yeah. And that's one of those things and that you couldn't even have said it better. People don't understand how much that it actually takes, you know, out of your day. People think when you're the boss that, do whatever. Yeah, it's easy. You're the boss. You have nobody to answer to. It's not the truth. When you're the boss, that means that you're the person that everything falls on your shoulders. And if you mess up, it's your fault. You know, if you mishandle something, or even if you have an employee that does something wrong, it's still your fault. And, you know, when you have 5 or 10 people off talking to people or doing work for, business owners, you know, in my case, you know, digital and things like that. In your case, if you break somebody's
items,
their lamp, you break their lamp, you know, it's your fault.
It falls back on you. You're going to be the one showing up. You're going to be the one showing up at the police station, the courthouse, or wherever it is.
Hopefully not.
It's you at the end of the day.
Right.
Yes. Hopefully
right.
not. But one thing I can tell you, it's fucking worth it.
It is. It is definitely worth it.
The freedom, just being able to wake up, set your schedule at times. But just, you know, you set it up. You make it happen. You bring in who you want to bring in.
Right.
You are that freedom, that could take that control of your life. Knowing that whatever you put into it is what you're going to get out at the end of the day or at the end of your fucking journey. It's so worth it. Knowing that you control it and it's not controlled by somebody else.
Yeah. Yeah. That freedom that you get, you know, I mean, it's a double-edged sword. You know, you have that responsibility, but you know, it's up to you whether you want to use that responsibility to slack off and you're not really going to end up as successful or successful at all, most likely. Or, you know, you use that, as motivation, like, you know,
exactly.
you end up getting to a point where it's empowering to know that you have done all this yourself, or you've built a team and you have a successful, like, well-oiled machine, or a machine that's like kind of sort of well-oiled, but it has a little bit more oil needed, you know? So either way, all those little steps, like, it's like raising, you know, I don't have a kid myself, but this is my kid. My business is my kid. And, you know,
good way of putting it.
So I guess at this point, the guest that you know and love, Miro, which is the host, you know, we're going to cover the topics that you guys probably want to know about him. You know, a lot of times he spends time interviewing other people, and you never really get a really good understanding of the man behind the microphone. So
here I am, everybody. Here I am.
So he's here.
Right now, right in front of you. I wish this was live, but it's not. That will be coming to you soon.
If this goes well, then we'll do some more live stuff for you.
It already went well because you're watching it right now.
That's true. So, and leave comments below. Leave comments below so I know.
Hit that like button, that follow button.
Like, share, all that stuff. Notifications on YouTube. You know what to do.
We appreciate it fully.
Absolutely. So here we are. So I had a few questions for you, Miro. And I think that these are things that most people would probably find interesting or important, you know, to know. I guess this new format and this new launch, Boss to Boss, it's very similar to what you were doing before. But what really made you decide to pull the trigger on a rebrand altogether? You know, you were like 90-something episodes in or more. Love the Journey podcast. So what was it that made you decide, you know, I think I could do this better or whatever? What was that?
It's a very solid question. Almost like it wasn't planned.
Almost.
Almost. Well, Love the Journey actually had 95 episodes. So let's get the facts out there, everybody. Get the facts out there.
Okay. So answer the question.
The reason was, I was documenting my journey of working at a 9-to-5, or at times it was 9-to-9, whatever it was. And I wanted to show everybody that someone like me, someone that is a CPA, that worked a desk job their whole life, I mean, I tried other things before that, could step out from behind that cubicle, from behind that office, that building, that, you know, being entrapped by the 20 bosses, you know, say that is the perfect job, the perfect career. I went to school for it. I devoted so much time, money, everything looked perfect. We could step out and get beyond and get past that. And as I was doing it, I wanted to document the whole thing. I wanted to show others that if I can do it, any of you can do it. Now, who am I? I'm just Miro Weeslow here. Like, we are slow.
Yeah.
Though we really, really are.
Really, really are.
Steve's got it down.
Yeah.
He knows what's up.
I remember. I wouldn't want to cut that.
And that's who I am. I'm Miro. I'm some Joe Schmo. And if I can do it, then you could fucking do it too.
There's
absolutely no reason why all of you can't do it and make it happen and take control of your life. I got to the point where Love the Journey was good and everything about it, it was great. It was everything it could have been. I started it off, you know, I said it was a joke because I used it as a motivational tool for one of my guys, not going to say his name, Nitai, to get him to come into work and start enjoy accounting a little bit more. Wow. And that was my little motivational thing for him as a joke. And the next thing you know, everybody at work started listening to it. Wow. And it was all around. And I'm like, all right, I'll do another one and another one. And I started interviewing a few people. And it's like, all right, this thing's actually not that bad. I always wanted to do something, whether it was video, audio related. Now I'm doing both. Here we are. Yeah. And that was a good way to start. I give so much props to Anchor, who I used to get me going. They have all the tools you need. It's all on an app. And that's what got me started. Everything was there, music, editing, you name it. And it was a great way just to get my feet wet. And kind of, I ran with it.
Mm-hmm.
95 episodes later, I ran with it. But I got to a point where things, you know, episode ideas weren't always there. I didn't have the set time, the schedules. You guys never knew when I was going to release the next episode. Right. And that wasn't fair to you. As being the listener, the watcher, that's not fair to you because you should know what to expect and when to expect it. And you deserve the best content at all times. And what we're going to do with Boss to Boss is that we're going to have 2 episodes a week. Every single week, we're going to bring you guys 2 episodes no matter what. Unless we're dead or who knows, something crazy happened with the world. We're bringing you 2 episodes a week. We're going to have one
for sure.
On Mondays is going to be our featured boss of the week. We're going to have some segments about the boss upcoming to the episode. And on Wednesdays, we're going to have a rant / recap, pretty much telling you stories of things happening in my day-to-day life. The business, the tips, you know, all the bad moments, all my, you know, sour grapes or whatever you call it, and the things that I'm learning from it. And with Boss to Boss, we have a whole structure. I brought Steven, you know, we're partnering up over here doing this, and he's my producer. And with this, we just, you know, we have certain roles, certain things that are going. This is more structured, more company based. And yes, I still love it. I still love what I'm doing. It's still me. I'm being real. I'm still doing this for fun. It's more of a passion project.
Sure.
With more structure and goals set in mind and plans. And I always talk about setting goals and setting plans. And here it is. We set a goal. We set plans. And we're achieving it. We're making it happen.
Making it happen.
And we're going to continue to make it happen.
Absolutely.
For all of you.
Yeah.
Bringing you the best content day in and day out.
By making it more of a business structured thing, what's going to happen is the viewers and the listeners are going to get a better experience.
Exactly.
That structure, people need structure. I think that's part of everything that we talk about, you know, on you know, what you've been talking about and what, you know, the upcoming episodes are going to be about, you know, structure and the planning and things like that. You know, the failures, the, you know, there's a lot of really awesome interviews coming up, and I'm super excited to, you know, be a part of this. We're going to grow, you know,
and we're all going to grow. We are doing this to help you grow. We're a team over here, and we're going to help you grow. This is going to be all for you, the listener, the viewer, but we're going to grow with you at the same time. That's the whole point. We're Absolutely. Learning from you just as much as you're learning from the people that are here on the show. These sure. people we're interviewing, we're going to pick their brains with everything that we want to know, with the hopes that it all comes back to you and you are making full use of it. This free content, you know, this content that's out here, and that you can make the most use and learn things that normally you'd pay hundreds, thousands of dollars, you know, go to school for things that the things you'll learn here are better than anything you would have.
Oh, that's a really good point. You know,
that's for sure.
You can go to school for 4 years, 7 years, 10 years, never leave school. You're not going to learn the type of things in real life that we're going to cover in this podcast. Real life experience, I think, is the most valuable. College and school is great for certain things, but
you need to get your hands dirty and make the mistakes yourself. Even though we tell you that we're going to make the mistakes for you, so you don't have to.
Yeah.
But you're going to be aware, and you're going to make these mistakes sooner or later. And you have to make them, but you'll know how to handle it. You'll know that these things are normal, that this does happen. And it was a matter of time before it happened to you. And that's where you, and that's, it's about how you get up at that point.
Right.
And what you do next. And being that being said, yes, this is going to be more structured. You know, you're going to know what to expect. But life throws you curveballs.
Of course.
You can never plan for the unexpected. So yes, we're going to have some structure. We're going to make sure this thing's the best possible thing it could be for you, best possible content.
Right.
At the same time, there will be new things. There will be things that we take out, things we add as we go along with it. I'm going to keep it real no matter what. I'm still going to be making you follow me on Snapchat. That's where you see my real day-to-day stories of things that you don't even see on Instagram or Facebook or YouTube. You know, that's Miro708 if you want to follow me.
There
I am. I'm exposing myself. You want to see day to day? You're going to see day to day of what it really takes.
Yeah.
That being said, what do you got for me next, Steve?
All right. Well, that was, you know, for that one question, that was a pretty good answer. So moving on, you know, basically we decided to work together for the most part, like we were saying before, you know, to make the episodes and the content better. But, you know, what do you think? What do you think that this partnership is going to do for you to make this thing grow?
The reason I got into this partnership and why I am doing this the way I'm doing it is because I want to focus on what I do best and what I know best. And that's people, networking, and just talking. And you can't get enough of this voice, right? I already know.
It's like magic.
And I found, I found the person, the team at Intrinsic that is complementary perfectly to my pieces, to my strong suit that I've learned, you know, through trial and error over time. And I just love giving back to people. I love meeting people. I love getting to know about them, interviewing them. And that's what I want to focus on. I want to focus on growing the brand, getting the best possible content out there for you. And I needed help. I needed some guidance, some structure in certain things, you know, getting these episodes out, getting them perfect, getting them produced, getting certain social media things done. And that's where this is all fitted in. And if I were going to do it all myself, who knows if this podcast will ever get out or ever explode. Who knows?
Right. Yeah.
That's a big part of it. And I knew I had a great product. I knew that I had devoted listeners, people that always hit me up and talk to me about it. I just needed to find a way to take it to the next level. I don't want to just sit there and just, you know, be happy with what I have and just, you know, live that normal, dull life and just, you know, be content with everything. I knew I needed to take it to another level. And that's why we teamed up over here, Steve and I, and Intrinsic specifically, to help me, you know, with these other certain things on the side, like the development, the production, social media, the things that are going to help me take this to the next level and grow and focus on what I do best. And I needed someone awesome and someone great. And that's when I came across Steve and Intrinsic.
Here we are.
And how do you feel about that? Well, what's your reasoning for it?
I told you before several times, you know, the reason that I initially kind of like, we kind of brushed shoulders again, because of the fact that I believed in what you were doing with the podcast. I liked what was coming out. I liked what I was hearing. I thought that it was something that people would actually want to hear, as opposed to 50 other people that want a YouTube channel, but they just want to talk about tacos and cats. Yeah, we're talking, you know, we have something to offer that'll actually work. Obviously, with my business and what we got going, it's a good fit. It's something that will bring what you got to offer to the next level.
I mean, I didn't think I would be here where I'm at right now. So I can't even imagine where we're going to be next year.
Oh, man. It's going to be great.
Come a long way. Long ways.
Sure. And that's the idea. And whether this is something that's going to inspire you or it's just going to be entertaining for you, that's up to you. But I know for a fact that this guy right here, he's going to get some really great interviews for you. We're going to chop them together so it makes sense in a way that works. And we're going to put it out there so you can find it. That's the most important thing. So this partnership here, that's what it's about. You know,
exactly what it's about.
Making it happen.
Yeah.
That is all for this episode of Bossed to Boss. Your next step is to visit BossedToBoss.com, where you will find proven techniques followed by professionals to help you make that next step. Again, that is Bossed, the number two, Boss.com. And remember, the time is now.